So here we are going to see EXA up counter. Okay, the initial value we are loading zero, and we are incrementing that particular value. For example, if the value initial value is loaded in inside the accumulator, so accumulator value is incremented every time. So in between, for every data increment, we can have a delay in the program. So here they are having a small delay function they are using for every data transfer. Okay. So initially we are loading a zero data, calling a delay, then incrementing a data, calling a delay, incrementing a data till the maximum value FF reaches. Okay, till the maximum value FF reaches. So let us see the simple program. Okay, so this is about the origin. Okay, leave. First, I clear accumulator. So that is, now the accumulator value is zero, just by clearing. So this is, even you can have an instruction called like move a comma hash 00h. Even you can use this also, no problem. Okay. So it is up to you. So clear a also. Will do the same operation. That is, accumulator will be having a data 00, clearing all the data which is in the initially. Okay, so let me call a call delay, absolute call delay. This is a subprogram, subroutine. Okay, subroutine which will jump to this location. Here, this is the delay program for every data transfer, that is every data increment. So in between there will be a delay. This is, we can design our own user program. We can design our own. Okay. That is not a big thing. The important thing is, after a call, what I'm doing, first I'm incrementing the data. So now accumulator value is increased to 1. Once again, I call delay. Fine. Now delay. Now I'm going to have a condition. That is, compare and jump not equal. So we can use not equal condition. Okay. Not equal condition. That is, accumulator value is not equal FF. Not equal to the data FFH, right? So it is not equal. The condition is true. Yes. The one is not equal. Accumulator value is 1. It is not equal to F. Condition is true. The loop will go to here. Until the condition gets false, it will be going on iterating. So second time, the data will be incremented. Then long call delay. Checking the condition. Condition is true because it is 2. It is not equal. It is 2 is not equal to FF. So condition is true. The loop will be executed. Then incrementing 3, having a delay. So this will continue till FF. Now your value in the accumulator is FF. Now I have final data. After all incrementing, now I have FF. So FF is not equal to FF. No, condition is false. This is the false condition. Okay. False condition. Now the instruction will, the control will move to next instruction. Short jump, dollars. That is, the control will stop here. This is a simple loop. Okay. Now program will be stopped. This is the exact program. Let us see what is delay. Delay, what it is doing? It is doing nothing. See, we are pushing one data to R2. We are pushing another data to R2. Pushing another FF to R1. Okay. Let us take 3 values. Check. Decrement and jump not zero, that is R1 is not zero. This is the one loop. Yes, it is not zero. Again, this will be executed. That is until R0, this particular here, the control will be here. Okay. Then the decrement and jump not zero. That is R0 is not zero. Go to back. This once again, this loop will be executed. So the control is, it is like this. It is like nested loop. Okay. So you can stop with one instruction also, no problem. Okay. So after that, so you have written to get back to the next instruction. That is after delay. The program will get back to the next instruction of call delay. That is delay program. That is where you call, where your subprogram you called, it will move to the next instruction from there. Okay. So that's it about the program. So if you want, we can execute this same program. Add the software now. Yeah, this is a simple your program. Always keep the label just left corner. So now I'll try to run, compile the program. Okay. So in this program, I no need of any input. I want to check the output. So where is my output? Say output is in the accumulator. Okay, output is in the accumulator. So to see this output, what you can do is, I'll try to move this value. Okay. Okay. Here I'll move, or wherever I want. Before, after, here I will. Okay. I can move this accumulator value to any port pin, and to check out, I'll move to port zero. And I will check how the data is changing. That is, it is varying from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to F4. Okay. I will run the program. Compile it. And I will run the program. Okay, this is my program, right? So I will run the program. Before that, I will open my input output, port 0. Okay. So now I will run the program. See here, you can see this. The value is counted 0, 1, 2, 9, A, B, C, D, like that. So it is showing in Excel form, but here we are counting it 8 bit binary starting from 0 to FF. Okay, so here you can see your value of increment, okay? That is how it is incrementing. Till FF, it will be incrementing. Okay, this is what the up counter is. So the next thing, I will share down counter. Okay. Simple three place we have to change few things. First, we have to load the high value to the accumulator. This is my first thing I should do. So we are placing high value now. Same long call delay, fine. Simple delay. Next, decrementing. We have to decrement. Okay. There we have incremented accumulator. Here we have to decrement the accumulator. Now accumulator is having F. After delay, we have FEH. Okay, fine. Then one more delay. Then we are going to compare. Compare and not equal. When it should not, I mean, when it should be equal in the sense, that is my final value. If it is, if I reach to final value, then I can have a condition to be false condition until it should be true. So that I'm placing my final value as 00H. Okay. Just repeat. Okay. Same program. Only three places. That is this instruction we have to change it. This instruction as a decrement. And here 00 you should place. That is my final value. Okay. So initial value, the final value we should change. And then decrement we should change for down counter. Same logic. Nothing different. So I'll take the same program. We'll go to software and so here, see, we have the only I told you already, the first value we should move FF to accumulator. Now we can have a delay, then decrement accumulator value, delay, check the condition, whether it has reached to the final value, that is 00, because it is a down counter. If it is not, just repeat, that is decrement accumulator, call delay, decrement accumulator, call delay, check for conditions. So this is the thing will happen now for down counter. So start with ORG. So you can give small letter also, no problem. ORG 00H. Okay. So let me execute the run. Let me run the program. Just debug the program now. The same, what you should do is, after decrement, you can move it to, see, manual they have not given, you can move it to some other, any port, okay, the accumulator value, you can move it to any one of the port. So where you want to see the result, okay, I'm just pushing my data and see my result, okay. So I need to run this once again. I'll compile and I'll run the program now. Okay. So here I will open input output port. Sorry. I'll open port 0, which I have used in the program. Run. See, now the value is decrement. Okay, this is all about extra value counter. That is, we are counting up, counting and down, counting. Right? So it depends on the application. You can develop your own counter. After 100 count, what should happen? Okay, this is all about decrement counter. So the same here, once again, we will see by decimal. So here I have shared. So here we are going to see BCD up counter now. That is, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now it is going to be 10. not 0A. It has to provide you 10H. As per our vision, 0, 10 is decimal. That is after 9, it is 10. After 9, it is 10. So this is what the binary coded decimal count. Okay. So it should be 10, 11, 12, 13. No E. So no the variable like A to F. It should not provide. So for that, what is the main instruction is, after, so here they are using decimal adjust. This instruction name is decimal adjust. Decimal adjust. I think you can go to the instruction set slide and you can check out what is happening here. That is nothing but whatever the data you got, from there it will add plus 6 to that value. So that is what it is happening. So here, for example, decimal adjust. Now we will start the program now. Just similar way, clear accumulator, okay, 00, delay, we'll have a delay here, we'll have a small delay, okay, so delay is no operation, okay, so then we'll move, that is add accumulator data with 1, okay, here just adding, okay, we have to use add instruction, so here, adding 1 with the accumulator, you will get 01 now. Finally, result will be stored in the accumulator. Now, we are going to adjust that value, whichever the generated value in XA, to the decimal value. That is, the data, the result will be adjusted to decimal now. So, this is the main instruction which converts your XA to decimal. Decimal adjust. Then long call delay, just have a condition, compare and jump not equal. What is the not equal? Till 99. So last value I'm placing here, checking the condition, that is accumulator value, 1 is not equal. So 1 is not equal, condition is true. True, it will get back to the addition instruction. Okay. We'll get back to here. So till the 99 you reach counter from 0 to 99, that is 100 count. So you can, it will be automatically adding 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus with the result. So this, for example, 2 plus 1 3, that is a value stored in accumulator once again. So that is adjusted to decimal adjust. Finally, decimal adjust value we are placing there. So delay is simple, so no operation here. So let us take the program. We try to execute in the software. So this is all about the delay. So no operation here. Fine. So just whatever, first clear accumulator. Now 0 is moved to the accumulator. Okay. So simple delay. So adding 0 with 1, answer is 1. The 1 is adjusted to decimal. Now the value will be shown in the decimal. That is, for 1 is 1. So till 9, no changes. If 10 comes, then 10 is, that is 0A is replaced with 10. Let us see how it is executed. So here nothing but, this is your final value. Until the value in the accumulator reaches 99H, the condition is true, this label will be executed. The label is placed here, that is adding 1, 1, 1. Continuously. Run the program. I will. So here, where I can move is, so here I can move to any one of the port register. I can move my data. That is after decimal adjust, my data is moved to the accumulator. So my result is in decimal form, which is in the accumulator. That is moved to port zero. So since I have changed this, I need to compile once again. Debug. So before running, take the port zero, which I have used in the program. Run. See here, you can see that 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 now. Okay. It is showing 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So it is binary coded decimal value. So in this way, you can view your data as binary coded decimal value. Okay. See, as per the system, it is showing hexa value only, but our conversion, this 61, 62 is BCD. Okay, as per my program logic, my conversion, I am taking that value as BCD. Okay, keep in mind, system is not taking that as a BCD. That is as a decimal. No, it is not giving decimal output. No, so we are converting that hexadecimal value to decimal, and we are saying it as decimal. Okay, so here you can see till 99 reaches, okay, the loop will be executed. So this is for up counter. So similarly for the down counter, the same way here, you can see I'm first I want to move 99 to the accumulator. So I'm moving 99 to the accumulator, simple delay. Okay, fine. Now I'm going to add accumulator with the value 99. So the result will be in the accumulator. So finally, it will be adjusted to decimal value. So it will come to 98 now. Okay. As after decimal adjust. So L call delay compare till it has to reach to 00. My just going downwards, so I'll be using 00H. Okay. So only this is the changes. So here, initial value I should move, the final value I should change. So you are here, we need to add 99 with your data. So this is for down counter. I'll take the same program. This is a simple delay. So start the program with origin. Fine. So after decimal adjust, move the data to the port zero in the accumulator. So my result is in the accumulator is moved to port zero. So now I can run this program. So before running, I just move to the, I just open port zero. And I'll run it. See, it will be counted from 98 like that. So it is down count. it is counting down. So